Hi, I'm Carla with Wiz-Tec Computing. Today I'll be going over some basic operations on iPOS to help you get started with your new system, or just to give you a refresher on what to do. So let's get started. Today I'll be showing you how to receive inventory onto a vendor account. There are two ways to do this. First, key in the vendor account number on iPOS and press the account number button. The vendor name and account number should show up on the top blue section of your screen. According to your purchase order received from the vendor, key in the number of units you are receiving of an item and press the times quantity button. Then you enter the total extended costs of all those products and press the dollar amount button. Next, you have to scan the barcode of that product or key in the product number. In this case, we'll use oil, so we'll key in 309 and auto. You should now be able to see that you're receiving that item from the vendor at that quantity and at that total price. Use the same steps to enter your entire purchase order. Alternatively, you can simply key in the quantity of your product and press one of your quick key buttons. This will also bring up the total based on the cost that you inputted onto your iPOS back office. To finalize the receiving, you want to press the cash button. This will simply let the system know that you finished receiving, not that you paid cash for your inventory. Once you press it, you will be prompted to enter a purchase order number and/or purchase order name. And that's it. You should be able to see a receipt showing what you received from the vendor and the prices that you paid in total. This will be posted to your back office. Alternatively, you can use the receiving button in the system's functions menu. So if you go to the home tab and then press system functions, you should be able to press receiving and it will bring up a window that will allow you to input the necessary information such as the vendor or supplier account, quantities, cost per item, and/or extended costs. You can then scan or type in your product number and add the items to the list. Then you must press post to finalize receiving. This will bring up the purchase order onto iPOS, and you must then press cash once again and enter the purchase order name and number to finalize receiving. And that's it. To see more tutorials on iPOS operations, please check out the iPOS Basics playlist on our channel. Thanks for watching.